Hi there, Eve here from Fresh Start. I just wanted to give you a quick review of the juicer that I will be testing out today, which is the Juico Uno. I'm just reviewing this for our friends at Thrive magazine. So I just wanted to have a quick chat with you about the juicer and show you it. I'm going to do a demonstration for you using the juicer. So first of all, it's a slow juicer. It's an upright cold press juicer. It's even slower than most on the market, and it's just 35 revs per minute, so it's really slow. Unlike a centrifugal juicer, where they go really fast, create a lot of heat friction, and tear up and shred your juice, you don't get as much yield for the produce that you put in. With a slow juicer like this one, it gently crushes and squeezes out every last drip of juice. So it's definitely worth the time and effort chopping up your fruit and veg, because you only have a small shoot in a juicer like this. So it's definitely worth the effort chopping up and spending a little bit more time preparing your fruit and veg just to get a good quality of juice. The difference you can tell straight away with a cold pressed juice to a centrifugal juice is you see the brighter colour where it's taken its time to juice it, and you see the there's no separation with the juice, so it's really a really good quality juice. So first of all, this juicer looks great in my kitchen. I've got every gadget going. I've got like coffee machines, blenders, food processors, everything. So what I love about this juicer mainly is the way it looks. Before even trying it out, I knew I really liked this juicer. It's a really slimline design, probably the smallest juicer I've seen actually, slimmest juicer I've seen. And I can't believe how light it is. It's definitely the lightest juicer I've used. So for the past week, I've just been testing out this juicer. I've made a couple juices with it. I've done some juices using harder fruit and veg. I've used carrots and beetroots, and it's coped with that really well. So I'm just going to do a demonstration for you, which is one of our Fresh Start's recipes, which is Green Goddess. It's just a very simple green juice, but it'll show you how well it extracts juice from the leafy vegetables like kale, as well as the tougher things that we usually find, which is celery. It can usually be quite a difficult task to juice celery in a cold press machine, as it can get clogged, but I found the Juico Uno just works on celery and pineapple really well. So I'm just going to do a little demonstration doing the Green Goddess. Now the Green Goddess juice is cucumber, lemon, ginger, kale, apple and celery. Okay, so I have all my ingredients here prepped and ready to go. So the juice is really quiet, you can barely hear that. I'm just going to pop a sieve on the juice on the top of the pitcher here, just so we can see the pulp that would have been in the juice. So what I love about the design is you can actually see through into the grinder. See your apples working through and the juice being extracted. Which I really like, because I think it just lets you take your time and you can see how everything's working through, so you don't rush the juicer. You shouldn't really need to use the plunger too much. It just helps push things through, but you don't really want to go putting too much of the juicer at once. It's always best to let the juicer extract the juice in its own pace. It handles the celery really well. The juice is only made of about 3 to 4 parts, so it's only a few parts, which is really good. It's a really good design actually. You've just got the lid, the juice bowl and the screw inside, so it's really easy to assemble and really easy to take apart and clean. And to be fair, I've only really needed to rinse the juicer, as most of the pot will work its way out, and then you only really need to give it a rinse, so it's really easy to clean. And then put back together. For slow cold pressed juicer, it's actually quite fast. I've only been doing this a couple of minutes and I've already extracted quite a bit. Obviously not the amount you get with a centrifugal juicer. You get a much finer quality juice. I'm just going to pop in some kale now. So there we have it. It looks like it's done. That's the green goddess for you. I'm just going to reverse the juicer just to make sure that we've got all the pulp out of the juicer. Pull this again. I've finished the juice and I put the sieve on here because I wanted to see if there was any pulp going through to the juicer. And as you can see, there's nothing in it. There's a little bit of froth. That's just where we've juiced kale. Sometimes it can cause a little froth. But there is no pulp there that it's caught. To be fair, you probably wouldn't even need to use a sieve. I just put it on there just out of curiosity, see if there was any pulp coming through the juice. I love a green juice, and that's made my green juice perfect. Didn't struggle at all with kale, with celery, so thumbs up for the juicer. I'm going to review it again, I'm going to do a couple other recipes and stuff, but so far, really, really, really enjoying this juicer. Love the design, love how easy it assembles, and love the quality of juice it produces as well. So, see you again for more recipes.